Welcome everybody to this 6-day faculty development program. Universal Human Values 2, Understanding Harmony and Ethical Human Conduct. So if you look into the objectives of this FDP, it aligns to the NEP 2020 aspirations. And which says education is fundamental for achieving full human potential, developing an equitable and just society, and promoting national development. So this has been discussed many times now. So I'm just recalling this. And also the model for the holistic value-based education that would be required for this to happen contains these three parts. One is the development of a humane world vision, and universal human values is something that can help to do that. Second part is the case studies of human thought, human culture, and we have very good examples from the Indian knowledge system. And the third part is world-class value-guided skills. That is education and practice of nature-friendly and human-friendly skills. And that would be required to prepare the people who can really do something about the aspired kind of society and the aspiration that we have for our nation. So all this has been discussed before, and AICTE has been making, you know, very significant efforts in this direction. In particular about universal human values, I just want to mention these five things. One is the mandatory student induction program, in which UHV1 is the core module. It's an introduction to the universal human values. It gets the student sort of ready and willing to look into these values. The second part is the mandatory UHV2 Universal Human Values 3-credit course, which is now made as a mandatory course in the model curriculum. Now universities have to take it up and do that, all that part. The third is the open electives and minor degree in Universal Human Values, which has recently been approved, and it will be available as MOOCs on the SOAM portal. Till you all are ready. If we are ready as faculty members to offer these courses, then you can offer them in your respective institutions. But till then, they will be available. These electives will be available in the SOAM portal with a proper credit transfer scheme. So your university can take advantage of that. The fourth one is extension into school education, and fifth is extension into adult or informal education. So AICTE has been making, you know, all these kind of efforts for incorporating human values in education, formal and informal. The targets that AICTE has set for faculty mentors, for faculty for teaching UHV1, and faculty for teaching UHV2, you can see the numbers that from every department of every college, they are expecting one faculty member from every department, from every college, for every 20 newly joined students. So if there are 20 newly joined students in the civil engineering department, then the civil engineering department must prepare one faculty member. If the mechanical engineering department has 60 students joining per year, then they must prepare 3 faculty members from the mechanical engineering department. So that is what 1:20 means. So as far as faculty mentors are concerned, the ratio is 1:20. And the minimum preparation that is required is at least a one-day, three-day UHV program, FDP, or a 5-day online introductory UHV FDP. and all of you have been through either of these, so you are well equipped to mentor the students. Of course, you have to do more than just attend the course, but that is minimum preparation. Similarly, for teaching UHV1, the ratio is 1:60. Again, from every department, this is very important that it is from every department. There is no special department for teaching universal human values. And the minimum preparation is at least 1 8-day face-to-face FTP, which is now not being run that much, but it is still available. Although it's not easy to do that these days in the COVID time. So the other option is the UHV Refresher 1 Part 1, which is 5 days online program. So that is for preparing faculty for teaching UHV1. The third is faculty for teaching UHV2, and that is what this particular program is about. That's part two. Both of these are required. The programs that AICTE has been offering are these five programs. The online first three are online programs. One is the introductory FTP on UHV. The second is the Refresher 1 Part 1. And the third is the Refresher 1 Part 2. And below are the face-to-face workshops, which are the first one, the three-day workshop, is now not being offered as a face-to-face workshop, but only as a five-day online workshop. And the last one is the eight-day, which is still being run on a case-by-case basis, particularly for the higher levels. Now, I have not mentioned all the higher levels over here, but these are the basic five programs that AICT is offering. Rather, four programs. One is not being offered right now. Now, the focus of this particular faculty development program is self-development. It is not focused on how to teach UHV2. It is focused on our development, your development and my development. If we are able to do that, then we can be prepared to facilitate our students also. We can facilitate them as co-explorers. We can help them to explore each of these proposals. So the very important thing to keep in mind during this whole workshop is to focus on ourselves. So when we say something, we should be able to take it to me rather than to our students or to somebody else or to a group, but to me as an individual, to you as an individual. So the focus of this FTP is self-development. And with that self-development at the base, we can be prepared as teachers who can teach UHV2 effectively, as co-explorers. Now, if you look at this course, it is called UHV2, Universal Human Values, Understanding Harmony and Ethical Human Conduct. It is a mandatory 3-credit course, and it is to be offered in the first, second, third, or fourth semester. 3 exclusive credits have been allocated for this course in the model AICTE curriculum. So now we'll discuss a little bit about the objectives of the course, the methodology of the course, and the orientational guidelines for the teachers, for the faculty members. So if you have gone through the material that was shared, you would have seen that the introductory course input is to help the students appreciate the essential complementarity between values and skills. So not only skills are important, but values are also important. It is to facilitate the development of a holistic perspective, a perspective that takes into account not only the job, not only, you know, the physical facility, but the entire reality that a student or any individual lives with. So it is to develop or help to develop this holistic perspective. And the third is to highlight the plausible implications of this holistic understanding in terms of ethical human conduct. Trustful and mutually fulfilling human behavior and mutually enriching interaction in nature. A lot of words, but when we talk about professional ethics, the approach is essentially developing that competence, developing that human conduct, rather than, you know, just talking about codes of conduct and oaths and things like that, which is written at the bottom of this particular screen. So the course is designed to facilitate the development of a holistic perspective through a systematic study of harmony in every aspect of living. It is for developing the competence and commitment to live with fulfillment in every aspect of life, so we can decide on our own right and have the courage and commitment to live like that. So for example, if we have understood respect, then we would live with respect regardless of if the other person is living with respect or with disrespect. So that's what it means. And the third is strengthening the commitment and competence for ethical behavior, work and participation in the profession. So the professional ethics part of it is based on what is written at the bottom, fundamental approach to professional ethics, where the major focus is on development of ethical competence of the individual rather than relying on, you know, the external fear and incentive modes of codes of conduct, oaths, whistleblowing and things like that. And over here, I won't go into all the details about the course methodology. It is self-explorational or self-reflective approach, which you have been through, and we'll go through it in more detail as we go along. And as far as the guidelines for teachers is concerned, in the part one of this workshop, we had of the refresher, we had done a whole session on how to share values, and we will in this also touch upon those, some of the important points. But two important points are that as a faculty member, as a teacher, we are co-explorers, we are facilitators, number one. And number two, we are facilitating the self-exploration in the student. We are not asking them to mug up something. We are not just transferring some information. We are not giving answers. We are helping the student to become self-sufficient, self-reliant, self-referential, so that they can find the answers, the right answers on their own right from within themselves. So these are the two important guidelines for teachers, and a lot of more guidelines are available in the teacher's manual and the recordings that we have already shared the links for. The course is divided into 5 modules with a total of 28 lectures and 14 practice sessions or tutorials. And these 5 modules are there. We'll go through each of these modules. We will go through each of the lectures, except for module 5, in which we are going to do a summary. And in the homework, we'll ask you to you know, go through the material that is recorded material on module 5. So there's a lot to cover, to explore, to reflect on. Now, if there are any quick questions, we can, you know, take those questions and then move forward to the next part. Yes, let's see. Professor Nachiketa.
Good morning, Rajul Bhaiya.
Good morning.
Actually, in the electives, you have mentioned UHB 3, UHB 4, UHB 5, UHB 6, and then UHB 8. So is there...
Oh, there should be 7 also. There should be 7 also. Sorry. Actually, it should be 3 to 8. Must be a typo there.
Yes, here.
3, 4, 5, 6, and 7.
Oh, there should be 7 also.
Yeah, there should be 7 and 8.
Oh, 7 is missing.
7 is missing. Yeah, good. Yeah. It should not be missing.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks for pointing it out.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Any other quick question? Yeah, Dr. Bhubaneshwari.
Dr. Tathagat, good morning, sir. Good morning to all.
We can take Dr. Bhubaneshwari first and then we'll come back to you.
Okay.
Yeah. Morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning, Bhubaneshwari.
Actually, you have mentioned about the open electives and minor degree in UHV, no? Actually,
yes.
Our students can undertake these courses through NPTEL.
Yes.
Actually, who are all eligible for taking this open electives and minor degree from the first year onwards? Are they eligible based on the curriculum? We can give them chance to take this open electives.
Yeah, we can share the content of the open electives. Okay. And once that is prepared, we will let you know. Okay. It will be available from the coming academic session.
So we can get the equivalence, no, sir?
Suppose what is that?
We can get the equivalence for attending this open electives.
Yes. There will be credit transfer facility for that.
Okay, sir.
Yes. The idea is that...
Actually, the content is not given, no, sir, for UHV 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, we are right now at UHV 2, so we are focusing on UHV 2. And when we talk about the others, we will certainly go into the contents of that.
Okay.
But the overall view of that, maybe on the last day, we will open that up. Parikshitji, can you make a note of it? So on the last day, we will share the details about the minor degree. In fact, we can share the whole document on the minor degree in the reminder mail. So that will be available to everyone then.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank
you. Yeah, nice. Good. Nice. Dr. Tathagat.
Yes, good morning, sir. I also have the same question regarding UHV 2 to 8 that whether the students will be doing these courses on MOOCs and NPTEL, or it will be class-based education means.
Yeah, that's what I said. Will initially be MOOCs-based.
Okay.
Till we are prepared.
Okay.
If you are prepared to offer a course, the UHV 3 or 4, etc., then it will be offered in the institute.
That is in which year, sir? In since our is an engineering.
It will be offered for the engineering program from the third semester. The third semester. From the third semester onwards.
Okay.
Yeah, that is why the UHV 2 course is going to be offered in the second semester. It's almost like the UHV 1 is offered in the first semester or before the first semester. UHV 2 is offered in the second semester and so on.
Okay.
Till UHV 8. So they have an option to take those courses. Right now there are 160 credits that were completed. AICTE added 3 credits for UHV 2, so it has become 163 credits. In addition to these 163 credits, a student can take more credits, and if they are able to accumulate 18 or more credits in a particular stream, they will be eligible for a minor degree in that stream.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. So now we'll go into the lecture number one. Just an idea about the modules. The 5 modules are there. Mentioned those 5 modules, but module 1 has these 6 lectures and 3 practice sessions. And one by one, we will go into the lectures. And the practice sessions we are going to do mostly as homework. Okay, because to play the video online, it takes a lot of bandwidth and so on. But, and you can certainly, you know, do that as homework also. So we are going to do these 6 lectures, and I'm going to go